Oh, 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 oh. Some trust in chariots, some trust in hoses, but we trust in the name of the Lord. Some trust in the...
You are killing people in the name of God, and you say that you are worshiping God. Which God is that? You think that God, especially in the New Testament, when His mercy, you heard the last song that was sung about the grace of God. When God sent His Son, Jesus Christ, He came to bring mercy to us from God. He came to reconcile us back to God. In John 14:6, He said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except by me. Jesus Christ, He actually nini hanya nini geska nini rei. Bem ezwa, urinu ba, Satan rina. So there's mercy now through Christ our Lord. He reconciled us back to God. Now we can come boldly to the throne of grace. Now we can call God again like it used to be, Abba, Father. Now there's no more fear. Now there's no more condemnation. Romans chapter 8 says, now if any man be in Christ, there's no more condemnation. And then in 2 Corinthians 5:17, He said, all things have become new. My brother, my sister, under the sound of my voice this morning, why don't you make peace with God? Why don't you just embrace the Father God? Christ has come to reconcile us back to the Father. So if you're not with the Father God, be careful. That could be, that is what is called spiritual fornication. You got it now? Okay, let me give you a few proofs. In John chapter 17 from verse 1 to 3, Christ was talking to the Father, not to man, but to the Father Himself. And He said to the Father, He said, the hour has come, glorify your Son, that your Son may also glorify you, as you have given Him power over all flesh, that He should give eternal life to as many as you have given Him. And this is life eternal, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach in the Hebrew, whom you have sent. When I tell people that Jesus Christ is the servant of God, some of them want to fight me. But they forget that the scriptures cannot be broken. In Isaiah chapter 53 from verse 10 to verse 13, the Bible says that God was speaking, said, by my righteous servant, okay, shall many be justified, for he shall bear their iniquities. So, listen, God is almighty. Last week and 2 weeks ago on radio, I told the world that God's name is not Trinity. No, 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 no. There's no word like Trinity in the Bible. God is one God. He is the Father and the God of our Lord Jesus Christ. This may sound controversial, I don't know so, but go check it. If you see that word Trinity in the Bible, come and challenge me. I will gladly repent. There's the Father God, yes. Jesus Christ called the Father the only true God. There's the Son of God, yes. That's the high priest in Hebrews chapter 8, verse 1 and 2. And in Hebrews chapter 7, from verse 20 to 25, the Son of God is the high priest of God. He is one that leads us to worship God. Okay? Hebrews chapter 2, verse 11 and 12. He worships God in the midst of the brethren. Amen? Now, if you go to the scriptures in the book of Revelation chapter 17. Oh, that's a call coming through. Let's take the call just before we sign off on this segment. Hello? Yeah, can you speak up, please? We are recording.
Hello, I want to talk with you.
Okay, on what?
About the Trinity.
Who is calling, please?
I am Reverend Silas.
Okay, please, be brief, eh? Take 2-3 minutes so that we can take more questions. And please, don't forget, be polite, because this program is for all Christians and Muslims and Jews. We are giving you a chance to speak up. Go ahead, 2 minutes, sir.
Sir, I want to correct all your errors.
Go ahead.
You are propagating false heresy.
Go ahead.
All what you are saying, it has been addressed since 3480. Now you are confusing the church. You say there's no Trinity.
Go ahead.
Please, you have to be careful.
Go ahead.
About what you are doing. Because all what you are saying, 300 years ago, the church council, in the council of Carthage,
yeah,
it has addressed all these issues. But now in the 21st century, you are confusing the church. You have to be careful.
Okay, sir.
Christ is perfect God. Christ is perfect man.
Okay.
I will give you some verses.
Just hold on, hold on, sir. Hold on, sir. Don't forget that we're not arguing. Can I just come in briefly, sir? 1 minute. I will speak for only 1 minute also, even though I'm controlling the airtime and the phone, but I will respect you. Is that okay, sir?
Yeah, Bob.
Thank you, sir. You said Christ is perfect man and perfect God, right?
Yes.
Is the Father, the Almighty Father of Jesus Christ, is he man at all?
Do you believe that God is omnipotent?
Hold on, hold on, sir. Hold on, sir. I repeat again, we are not arguing. By the way, we are on air. Don't forget we are on air. So if
I'm
you cannot...
You. I say, sir, do you know that God is omnipotent?
Let's take the question one by one. If you don't come...
Can God do anything impossible for him?
Sir, if you cannot respect the people
and
listening
God
to us...
Okay.
I don't want to cut you off, but please.
But don't confuse the church. All what you are saying is
okay. I will have to answer you now properly. Is that okay?
Yeah,
okay.
Sorry.
Now let me quickly answer our dear brother Reverend Silas, because this is a very serious point. Number one, God our Father is not a man, he's a spirit. The Son of God said in John chapter 4, verse 23 and 24, he said, God is a spirit. And those that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. The Son of God, I do not deny his sonship. He is the Son of God, but he's not the Almighty God. Brother Silas said, God is omnipotent. In John chapter 5, verse 30, Jesus Christ said, I can of my own self do nothing. As I judge, as I hear, I judge. And my judgment is just, because I seek not to do my own will, but the will of the Father who has sent me. So Jesus Christ is not omnipotent. Now, in John chapter 14, verse 28, Jesus Christ also said, if you love me, you would rejoice that I go to the Father, for my Father is greater than I am. Now, remember something, Reverend Silas and everybody listening. He said at the Council of Carthage, this discussion was had. Actually, he made a small historical error. It was in the Council of Nicaea, under Emperor Constantine, in AD 325. That was when, historically, this discussion was had. And what they did was to oppress the minority. The Emperor of Rome, who himself is an idol worshipper up to today, he was one that ruled over that council. Can you imagine a pagan king, a pagan emperor, presiding over a meeting of believers? It was at that conference that Emperor Constantine and his acolyte, his accomplice, one bishop of Egypt, Bishop Athanasius. That was when they now ruled that Jesus Christ must be the Almighty God who came to die for our sins. Can you imagine the sacrilege? Can you imagine the abomination to say that the Almighty God can die? And you are saying I should keep quiet? You may think I'm in the minority, but you are very wrong, my brother. I've been doing a vox pop amongst Christians on this issue for some time now, for many years now, and I've discovered that many Christians, despite the dogmas of the different churches, they do not believe that Jesus Christ is equal to the Almighty God. Jesus Christ is the Son of God, and I will believe in him every day of my life. Without him, I have no access to the Father. If you go and read the scriptures in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 18, the Bible says, and all things are of God. Let me finish this answer, please. All things are of God, who had reconciled us to himself by Christ Jesus. Jesus is the way to God. Now, Brother Silas, don't forget also that in the book of John chapter 17, verse 1 to 3, which I quoted earlier, Jesus Christ himself called the Father the only true God. Okay? And now, listen, let me give you the final proof. You may not understand yet, but go open the scriptures. Write down, please, Reverend Silas. In the book of Psalm 110, from verse 1 to 4, Prophet David prophesied that God swore with an oath that the Lord, the Son, the Messiah, is a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. And that is why in the book of Hebrews, chapter 7, verse 20 to 25, Hebrews chapter 7, from verse 20 to 25, what happened? Paul repeated that same prophecy. He said, God, the Lord swore, I will not repent. You are a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek.
Others trust in their kings, but we trust in the name of the Lord. When the arm of flesh will fail them, we'll still be standing tall.